Hi, I'm Britt with Garmin's product support team. I want to tell you about some exciting changes available on the latest software update for Enduro 2, Epix Gen 2, Fenix 7, Mark Gen 2, or Tactix 7 Adventure Series watch. In our last software update video, we covered features including HRV status, training status 2.0, training readiness, the race widget, cycling ability, HRM confidence, the new fish activity, full e-bike support, reference point, Sat IQ, some user interface improvements, and advanced multi-sport editing in the Garmin Connect app. If you have not yet reviewed this video, see the annotation to watch it now. Now let's dive into what's new. First, we'll cover new training and health additions, starting with Morning Report. You'll automatically receive this update if your watch is paired to Garmin Connect application, or if you've enabled Wi-Fi sync. The Morning Report will provide you with a daily summary of helpful information. This includes a daily greeting with the time, date, and weather. Plus, you can scroll down and access our new training readiness and overnight HRV status cards. Training readiness provides a score based on your sleep quality, recovery, training load, and more. While overnight HRV status plays a big part in understanding how your body is responding to stress, strain, or illness, monitoring it over time will provide you with a more accurate status to suit your lifestyle. Other cards available in the Morning Report include sleep, body battery, step goal, weekly intensity minutes, and women's health tracking, if enabled. To learn more about the Morning Report, training readiness, or HRV status, see the links in the description. Next, we'll talk about wrist-based run power. Run power is used to provide a reliable way to measure the actual exercise load for your activity. You'll be prompted to add the run power data screen when you begin your next run activity. By default, this new run power source will be set to smart mode. Smart mode will automatically switch from using wrist heart rate to the heart rate strap when detected. To learn more about run power and its settings, see the links in the description. Along with wrist-based run power, we'll now post your running power zones information into the activity summary after you complete a run activity. The last health and training addition is support for heart rate chest strap in yoga, breathwork, and health snapshot. Your watch will automatically look for the previously paired HRM strap when starting one of these activities. For help pairing your heart rate monitor, see the link in the description. The next activity and app additions we'll discuss are Anchor, Sail, and Sail Race. The Anchor app will allow you to mark an anchor point and set a drift radius. The Sail app provides important information such as distance, timer, and speed over ground. The Sail Race app includes Regatta Timer to help you prep before passing the starting line for your next race. We've also included a Tides widget glance to quickly give you high and low tide information for your current location or specific set location. In addition to the new boating features, you can now add backcountry snowboard. This lets you manually switch between climbing and descending tracking modes. You can also accurately track your statistics. You can also find a new disc golf activity to track your distance, keep track of the time, and see when the sun will set. Along with the new activity types, there's also a few new features added in this update. This includes grade adjusted pace, next fork, and auto rest for ultra run activity. Grade adjusted pace is a running data field that will provide an estimated flatland equivalent for your current pace at grade. It is an average pace adjusted by the steepness of the grade and is a way to better understand pacing over varying terrain. Now let's discuss next fork. Next fork is a data field that allows you to see the distance to the trail intersection for a nearby trail. It can be added to the map screen of certain outdoor activity profiles. For instructions adding either grade adjusted pace or next fork to your watch, see our customizing your data field video for your watch. The last new activity and app addition we'll cover is auto rest for ultra run. During an ultra run activity, your watch will automatically keep track of time spent at an aid station or checkpoint. With auto rest, you don't need to worry about pausing your run. To enable this feature and learn more about auto rest, see the link in the description. The last section we'll cover is watch user interface changes. This includes more haptic feedback when using your finger to scroll up or down or scrolling through radial fields. Thanks for taking the time to learn about what's new in the latest update for your Garmin device. To learn more, see our other videos or visit us at support.garmin.com.